This screencast involves an internal flow problem with a constant surface temperature. And what we have is water that's flowing at a mass flow rate of 3 kilograms per second through a 50 millimeter diameter tube. So that's 0.05 meters. It's to be heated from 30 degrees C to some outlet temperature, and that's what we're looking for. The length of our tube is 12 meters, and the surface temperature is maintained at 110 degrees C. So the first thing we need to do is look up the properties of water. And so the first thing is the heat capacity, which is 4181 joules per kilogram K. Our viscosity is 547 times 10 to the minus 6 newtons seconds per meter squared. Our K, and remember it's the K of the fluid, is 0.643 watts per meter K. And finally, our Prandtl number is 3.56. And looking up these, or showing you these properties, probably means that we're going to have to use some kind of correlation to find H, our heat transfer coefficient. So we are going to let delta Ti equal T of the surface minus Tmi, and our delta T out is going to be T of the surface minus Tm out. Now, our heat transfer is through convection, which is M C sub P delta Ti minus delta T out. But it's also equal time to H, which is the overall average heat coefficient for the entire tube, times the surface area, times our temperature log mean. And hopefully you remember, whenever we're working with a constant surface temperature, the best way to use our Tm in and out is in a logarithmic fashion. So our delta T log mean is delta To minus delta Ti over ln of this delta T out delta T in. And the problem with this, as you can see, is we have our Tm out involved in a number of the different terms. So the first thing we can do is take the delta T out from the natural log term. So now we have Ts minus Tmo divided by Ts minus Tmi equals exponential of minus H A sub S surface area M dot sub C sub P. And so now, if we want to solve for our Tmo, it's just Ts minus Ts minus Tmi times the exponential of minus H A sub S M C sub P. So when we look at that equation, we see that we have everything we need except for H. And so we're going to have to use a correlation for internal flow to find our H. So the first thing we do is find if it's turbulent or laminar. So our Reynolds number is 4 times the mass flow rate over pi d mu, and this equals 1.397 times 10 to the fifth, certainly over that 2300 that we need for laminar flow, so it is turbulent. That means that we can use the Dittus-Boelter correlation, where the Nusselt number equals 0.023 Reynolds to the 4/5 and Prandtl to the n, where n equals 0.3 for cooling and 0.4 where we're going to be using it for heating. So when we calculate our Nusselt number, we come out with 499.3. Our H equals K over D times the Nusselt number, which is 64 21 watts per meter squared K. So finally, we can put it into our equation that we have before, where TMO equals the surface temperature, which is 110, minus 110 minus 30 exponential of minus H, or minus 6421. So our surface area is pi dl, or 1.885 meters. And we divide this by the mass flow rate, which is 3 kilograms per second times that C sub P. And when we finish calculating, our TM out is going to equal 79.5 degrees C.